editing this video, I realized there were two stories that needed to be told. One was definitely for the hungry athlete. Oh. The other was just my moral compass screaming at me that people need to start talking about this. So without further ado,
greens, blues, pinks, purple, orange, because they have the algae in their tissues, just like land plants come in all different colors, corals come in all different colors. That's the misperception that people have, is that most corals are very colorful. Now, if you would have gone in the reef, you mentioned the depth of the water, if you went to the reef flat, the very shallow water, you would have seen mostly dead coral. That was mostly alive early this year. Overall, we lost 35% of the coral cover north of Cairns in 4 months with this big bleaching event that we had.
And can you elaborate on that last bleaching event that you had? Talk a little bit more about
it. It was the biggest bleaching event ever recorded on the planet. It affected 93% of the reefs on the Great Barrier Reef.
Can you explain bleaching events a little bit deeper?
Okay, coral bleaching is a natural phenomenon. It happens when the water gets warm over 29, 30 degrees Celsius. The corals lose their symbiotic algae, they turn white, hence the term bleaching, and they starve to death. That's a natural phenomenon, but now that we have human-induced climate change, these bleaching events are happening more frequently and more severely as time goes on. We all argue about the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, but nobody's paying attention to what's happened in the ocean. All this carbon dioxide is now diffusing in the ocean for the last 60 years and forming carbonic acid. They reckon by the end of the century, the ocean will be so acid the coral reefs have a really, really hard time. Coral reefs can actually dissolve away, along with all our seafood.
What's something that you think everyone should know about the reef that they don't seem to pay attention to, or they don't bring enough attention to?
Corals are like trees. They absorb carbon. If you pick up a piece of coral, you feel the weight in it. And probably more than half that weight is absorbed carbon dioxide. Trees absorb carbon. But if you look at the fact that we're losing our coral reefs and our forest, you can see that we're losing the ability to absorb all this excess carbon we're putting in the air, which is now getting in the ocean. Realize we have one planet Earth, one planet Earth only. Act accordingly, we would pass the reef and the planet on. If we don't, it doesn't really make any difference. Because it doesn't matter what we do, if we make good or bad decisions, the coral reefs will come back with or without the human race. Because people need corals, corals don't need people.